4, number 4 by Big Black Delta. It is 12 songs, 47 minutes long, so on one of the longer ends of what we reviewed. Mm. And Sean brought up Big Black Delta in a music recommendations episode. I'll take you away to like intro it.
Yeah, so I talk about Big Black Delta because he's an artist that he's been around for a little bit, kind of like the indie underground scene of like, he's done so much different work where he kind of had like that Jai Paul sound in the early 2010s. He morphed into more of almost like a straight techno maker for a wild house. He did alternative rock, he did indie rock, so he's done a lot of different stuff. And he released some singles earlier this year, the first single being Summoner, and I'm like, oh shit, this is like more of that like deep electronic style of music, like almost like Deadmau5 gets really angry. And I'm like, okay, let's see what happens, and whether he puts in an album. And then a couple other singles came out, and I was listening to it. I'm like, okay, this album's gonna be eclectic as fuck. And it's definitely eclectic as fuck, but
yeah, because Summoner does Summoner, which we put in, we mentioned in our music recommendations mm-hmm. episode, is a very electronic song. Pretty
like I call it the dystopian electronica.
It's techno, like, yeah. It's not like quite progressive house, but it's definitely firmly EDM. It's techno.
Yeah. But the album doesn't start off like that at all.
It doesn't start off like that. It doesn't end like that. It has moments where it dips into techno, kind of as a compliment to its overall rock thing. But I kind of compared it to like Radiohead and its extensive, like how it uses, it borrows from these different genres and sounds to build a larger thing that's kind of coalesced around more alternative rock.
Yeah, so it started off with Lord Only Knows, which is one of my favorite rock songs of the year so far. I think because what I was talking about, like, with The Killers, you can make a decent, like, alternative rock song, but it's going to be kind of cliche with the way they do it. But Big Black Delta did it very good, where he's like, Lord Only Knows What You Want. And it's stuff with, and like, has that theme going on in the background. It starts off kind of like really big, almost Van Halen-style rock, but then it morphs into this beautiful different thing with a piano going on in the background towards the end. Kind of synthesizers going on along with the instrumentation. It's a lot to listen to, but it's something that's very unique and different in that regard for an opening track. I'm like, holy crap, this is a lot. And I listen to that song a lot. It's also one of his singles too that I did listen to a few times. A fantastic opener. I was like, okay, now I don't know really what to see because he started off with that. Let's see what happens with the rest of the album. Vessel Go after that is more of like your kind of standard rock song. I'm like, okay, he went more into that alternative rock, kind of like harder alternative rock into that. I'm like, I'm okay with that.
It sounds like a Franz Ferdinand or any sort of like standard alternative rock.
Politics of Living is good after that. I think the lyrics of that is kind of cool. It's like literally live your politics. Live what you say, mean what you do. And I love that theme. Still kind of into like your standard rock themes. I was like, okay, first song's fantastic. Second two songs were okay. Let's see what happens. And then they bring in Summoner after that, which is straight like a techno dystopian world. I'm like, whoa, it's just, I didn't expect him to put it there. And it just gets at you and it's angry and it's just going at it.
If anything, the song sort of breaks up different parts of the album. Because if you get into later, after that,
yeah,
like, Ballad of the Codependent, it's sort of like a slower part of the album until mm-hmm. another thing.
Yeah, exactly. So then it goes into Ballad of the Codependent, which is slower. Sunday, Heaven is kind of picks it back up. Heaven Here I Come is a fantastic rock song. It's very, very good. Again, he's using more of the synthesizers, but not being cliche with it and not overdoing or overstepping anything. Kind of keeping in within what he's done before, but moving his sound further. It's still like an eclectic.
And to me, it sounds like a more modern, like rock, alternative rock spin than even what The Killers did earlier this week.
For sure.
Like when we were talking about in The Killers review of how can you take, I'm not off the top of my head, the Big Black Delta has been working as long as The Killers have.
No, like, he's been doing like 2008 or 9, so he's been around for a while.
He's still in the decade. I would consider him like a 10s kind of person.
For sure.
But like, you're taking sounds that would be sort of normal in the early aughts, and you are modernizing them, updating them, mm-hmm. upgrading them, really, for the modern time. And it works out in Heaven Here I Come.
And then you have Canary right after that, which is...
Canary.
Which is straight up another like techno style song, which just goes into it. It's fast paced. That one's only like 2.5 minutes within it, but this straight electronica, which is really cool to have right after that track. And I was like, I thought when I was listening, right when I got up to that song, I was like, okay, this is like him almost trying to do a Kid A style of like, you have Idiotech, then you have Optimistic. You have like a bunch of different sounds that not many people can pull off. And I was like, okay, let's see how
And not many people can pull off putting them together. But even though you're going on a lot of different rides, I can play through the album and it doesn't feel very alien.
No, it still feels, it's not like Bjork, where Bjork can feel super alien at times. It's not that eclectic where it can alienate people. It's more like you can still get into it. The only thing is that the ends, I didn't like the ending tracks. White Lies was okay, but Killing Me, Air Conditioned Dork, and Yes were just, it really slowed down. Air Conditioned Dork and Yes were almost like instrumental style pieces that I wish he worked on a little bit more, maybe have done up, because the rest of the album was amazing. I really liked it. The last couple of tracks were just, they didn't land that plane well. It like skipped off the runway a few times. You still land, like nothing came out of it, no oxygen mask or anything, but it was just like, flight was good, landing was rough.
I do like Air Conditioned Dork. It has some like nice muted piano in,
well, yeah,
in
I
the
do
background.
Like it, yeah.
It's a nice almost, again, this is the, remind me the most of a Radiohead project, because you have these like ethereal, echoey voices in the background, mm-hmm. a soundscape.
I just wish they didn't do it for two tracks in a row. Because they did that with Yes right after, because I do like Air Conditioned Dork, but you did it with Yes as well, and I'm like, okay, I'm like, is this the last track? And it ends. I'm like, it left you just a little too much of a lull. I wish it wrapped it up, because Air Conditioned Dork, if you did another song, like if you click out Yes, you could end on Air Conditioned Dork, but you can't do two in that, because it lulls you out too much, is my thing.
That's pretty fair.
But I think it's... he's an artist that doesn't get a lot of recognition because he's a smaller artist, but I think this is one of my favorite albums of the year. I don't think it'll get album of the year at all, but it's still one of those things that there's a lot to listen to with this album. There's a lot that multiple people will like of different genres, and there's something that not many other artists are doing.
So, yeah, if you're one of those genre hoppers who's listening to Audioface, like me, and this is like looking for some little random extra little thing to add to your week. Big Black Delta did
and then
a
also,
good job.
Yeah, and also look at his other discography too, because he has a lot of other work that is fantastic. So I think this is one of his stronger albums. Again, I just wish it ended a little bit better, and then it would have been like up there of my favorites. But solid.
Just could have stuck the landing. Because exactly. I get what you mean. Like with the last two, usually I think artists maybe fall into a trap of wanting to make the last two songs sort of similar so they work together and help end the album,
yeah.
right? But you even want to have some separation between those last two songs yes. and make them a little bit different and distinct.
Exactly.
Again, Don't Get Lost in Heaven, Demon D. That's the
gold
standard.
I was going to say, that is the gold standard. There isn't many else that can do that. Maybe, what is it, Contact for Random Access Memories, I think is the last one.
Yeah.
What, Doing It
it's
Right
like
in
Motherboard
Contact?
In Contact.
Or some Motherboard in Contact. Like, Demon
D. Doing It Right in Contact.
Doing It Right, yes. It's course, Doing It Right in Contact. Like, that's the other gold standard. Like, there's not many people that can do that.
Yeah.
But anyways, this is like a solid, let's do...
I'm going with my 10 or 11 crush.
Yeah,
comments.
I was going to say,
this is
two big crushes that happen. Once at the pretty beginning of the race, once towards the end, and the race ends under a caution and everybody's sad.
Yeah. No deaths, no injuries.
No deaths, no injury, but everybody's like, I got to end under caution. Damn, I guess that's what's got to do.
It's lame. Yes. But a good album.
But a good album, exactly.